Mobile devices, such as phones and tablet computers, can provide flexible and timely access to learning resources and learning experiences. Designing a mobile application to address a unique problem or serve a specific niche task is possible with some basic programming skills and an innovative idea. Helen Ginn, a biochemistry undergraduate at Magdalen College, did just that.
Well, it all started in the summer of 2010 when I was doing an internship at the Division of Structural Biology in Oxford. And I was working on a particular structure which I realised I wanted to carry around with me, but my laptop was quite heavy and I didn't really want to bike it up to the lab, so I decided to see whether there was an application on the iPad which I could use instead to display the structure. And it turned out that there is an app available, but unfortunately it didn't have many features, and then I decided, is there any way I could improve on this? And I started out slowly trying to emulate the features that that app had, and eventually I realised it was quite easy to add extra features and turn it eventually into a full-blown application. I developed CMOL on my MacBook because you need an Apple computer in order to write these apps. Unfortunately, Windows isn't, or Linux isn't usable. I used the development environment Xcode, which Apple provides. I wrote it in Objective-C, which is a language for Apple computers only, which is built on top of C. So if you learn C, then it's quite a good step to learn Objective-C. What you do need is a membership to the development centre of Apple, which costs about £59 a year. But you can make back the money through your apps, and you can have as many apps as you like on the App Store under that £59 blanket fee. So that's a yearly thing. And after that, it took me about 4 weeks to write the whole thing. I was working quite intensely, but I'd already had about a year's experience with programming, which helped a lot, but this was my first time programming 3D modelling applications. Well, if you're just starting out, then you should be ready for some frustration, because learning a new language is a particularly frustrating task, and usually you don't know why it's going wrong, but eventually if you keep playing and experimenting, then you will eventually get a feel for the language and it will become a lot easier. If you're starting out on any programming application or anything at all, make backups, because you will eventually break your code, not know why, and have to go back to an earlier version. And the more earlier versions you have, the easier this will be not to lose some good code. And finally, if you're learning Objective-C, then you should really learn some C first. This is only really relevant to Apple development, but C is definitely a ground level for Objective-C, and it's a good idea to get some things under your belt like pointers, which are used a lot in C, because these do play a role in Objective-C as well, and otherwise it won't make sense. Each year the university supports students from across the university in the annual Ox Talent Awards for the innovative use of IT. The university also provides programming courses in PHP, Perl, Java and MySQL, which are very useful languages, especially for web development. And if you do attend those courses, then you also can attend drop-in sessions, which happen for anyone who has a particular problem in IT or programming.